Yo, what's good, everybody, man? This is Exacto, bro, back again with another banger for y'all. Appreciate everybody for the love and for the support lately. Y'all really been blessing my ass. Let's keep going. 2K22 is a great game. I'm gonna be playing next year, most year, but what I will say in this video will apply to next and current. The badge is do work the same to my knowledge. So please like the video if you enjoy the content. Sub to the channel if you're new. Share this video with a friend that is ass at the game. I know a lot of y'all are ass too. So let's just pretend that you're good. So share it for a friend and tell him, you ass, my brother. You know what I'm saying? So anyways, what I'm gonna say about these badges is gonna be applied to pretty much every build. These are not the best badges in the game in every category. There are badges that, one, see nobody using. Two, I think are very, very, very important for the current meta of the game. And three, most importantly, they are universal and they are applied to almost every single playstyle. So almost everyone will get value out of these badges, unless you're obviously in certain categories, you're not a shooter or you're not a fucking slasher at all, then obviously disregard those badges. But I'll be making more videos on position and playstyle specific badges, so please stay tuned for that. Sub to the channel. And with these badges, any tier will be good. There are value on bronze or silver, but all the way up to Hall of Fame, obviously it's whatever. While we're on the topic, if you want 4 extra badge caps, not unlocks or badges like, you know, that pop up, 4 real extra badge caps on top of your existing caps on your player, check out the video. It's going to be in the description, and there's going to be a little pop-up in the top right corner which you can click on right now and learn how to do that in just a couple hours of work. You know what I'm saying? Also, the last 2 badges for the playmaking and the defense, it's going to be 1 from each category that I'm gonna show y'all, but those last 2, you gotta have those on, bro. If you don't have them on, you're gonna be just a shit teammate, bro. And those badges will literally increase your fucking win percent. I'm not trolling, bro. Like, the small plays and the small situations in the game make a difference. But without further ado, let's get into the vid and y'all enjoy the content. Have a great day, bro. All right, so over here is the first badge that nobody is using and talking about. And I was almost gonna include the counterpart for this badge as the underrated badge, but that badge is becoming not underrated. You know what I'm saying? And the badge I'm talking about is Ball Stripper. Bruh. And the badge that you wanna use is gonna be Unstrippable. You know what I'm saying? It's ridiculous. I've been playing, whether you're an inside big like me right now, or you're a fucking outside guard, or you're a slasher, you're an isoer, the more people get that Ball Stripper badge and the more people that get steal and realize that pressing square in this game is, wouldn't say overpowered, but definitely a little bit OD, you're gonna wanna have this badge. Getting ripped out of a dunk or a layup in this game will, even if it looks like it went off the opponent, it will almost always be the opposition's ball. There is no worse way to lose the ball than attempting a 2. So you definitely want to have this badge. The tiers, I would recommend having it on, like I said, bronze or silver, but any tier that you want to have it on. If you're probably ISOing, you know what I'm saying, or if you're an inside big man, definitely recommend putting this on at least gold. As you see, it only costs 3 points to have it gold, and it's 1-2-3. It has the 1-2-3 split for bronze, silver, gold. I wouldn't go Hall of Fame. That's a little bit ridiculous unless this mechanic becomes so overpowered and you feel like it's happening to you a lot. But definitely run it on something, because you don't want to be coughing up points at the rim in such a bad way. And then it becomes a transition, even if it doesn't go out of bounds on you. You got, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to be getting ripped out of dunks and layups, period. All right, the next badge that we are going to talk about is, of course, the fucking Sniper badge. If you have not used, I don't see many people using this, and I don't know why. It's not even that expensive for the first 2 levels. It's only a 1-2-4-6 split, so bronze or silver, it's not even costing you anything. This badge is, I think it's unlocked by getting like 80 mid or 83 points, so everyone can pretty much get it up to Hall of Fame, you know, everyone that has shooting in their build at least. And this badge is a combination of flexible release, but not like the, as you see, it actually punishes you in the description for shooting a late or early. But if you're shooting lates or earlies, you need to get off 2K, you need to uninstall the game, and you gotta go play Roblox. You know what I'm saying? Go do something else with your life if you're shooting lates or earlies in 2021. You know what I'm saying? So, and those shots will not go in regardless. So without this badge, if you're making lates or earlies, I don't know what's going on. This badge is definitely gonna help you make not only your slightly early, slightly late, so you're just outside the green window, so it's kind of like a flexible release, but rewards you for still having decent timing. It does pop up on greens, which tells me that this badge will definitely help you achieve more shots that you time perfectly, which is literally a free boost for doing a basic task of pressing your square button and letting go at the right time. It's a free boost to every jump shot you take. It's been helping me a lot. It will help you a lot. Make sure you have it on every build you have with shooting. Corner lock, spot up, popper, center, guard, I don't care. Until they do something with this badge or until the game changes, you need to have this badge on your player. All right, the third badge, and these two are definitely gonna be the ones that you want to have on every single player. Glue hands. It is achieved by upgrading your ball control to a certain tier. As you see, it doesn't take absolutely anything to get it, at least on bronze. And it will change. This is needed for a guard, for a sharp, for a lock, for a post score, for a center. Catching the ball is an integral part of basketball. And when they add a badge in the game to do that action, you're gonna wanna fucking have it, because that means without the badge, you're gonna have problems. You know what I'm saying? And I've been having problems. Even if the guard has bullet passer, everything that the guard could have, you're gonna catch, you're gonna stumble, you're not gonna be able to make a move right away, which is, this game is all about speed. The chase downs are ridiculous. The steals are ridiculous. The contests are ridiculous. You wanna get the ball and put the ball in the hole or do what you gotta do, you know what I'm saying? So make sure you have this badge at least on bronze on every build, and the higher the better. I've seen people running this Hall of Fame as a guard, especially in Pro-Am, where there's five players on the court, like I said, but on every single court, except for 1v1, obviously, you're going to want to have this badge. It's phenomenal. Definitely try it out. And on to the last one. All right, the last badge I'm talking about is going to be Hustler. I don't see anybody using this, and I don't know why. So far, I've had a chance to try it out on just bronze, and by God, does this badge make a difference in every game mode. 1v1, 2v2, 3v3, you freaking name it, bro. Basically, what this badge does is, if you're an OG and you play 2K16, there was a badge that was called, I think it was called Scrapper. This badge literally gives you Usain Bolt speed anytime there's a loose ball on the court. Your player goes from, like, say you're a tall, slow-ass center, this game literally turns you into Usain Bolt. If other people don't have it on, it's like they're standing in place. You know what I'm saying? This is, I don't know why it's linked to perimeter defense, but as you see, it only requires a 60 perimeter defense to get it on Hall of Fame. And most of y'all want to have it on bronze, so it requires a 30. Every build in this game can get a 30. Have this badge on bronze. A lot of the rebounding in this game, everyone that's a center has a 90 plus rebound. You will almost never see a center with under a 90 rebound. Ever. Some guards have rebounding pretty high too. Everybody has a rebound rating because of the build system, which I love the build system, but everybody has a rebound rating. So you're definitely gonna wanna have this badge, because a lot of boards are not even gonna be decided about who can out jump each other. Cause if somebody has position, chances are you ain't getting that board, Brody. How do I tell you? You're not getting that board, man. Unless your vertical is incredibly higher, or that dude is a bot and doesn't know when to press triangle. You know what I'm saying? This badge is gonna help you run around somebody and get to the ball if it's a loose ball. That's gonna be a difference maker in many, many games. For a point guard, if you're crashing out the corner, this badge is gonna turn you into the fucking amazing Flash, bro. This badge is gonna make you teleport around the court defensively anytime there's a loose ball on the break. It doesn't even have to be a rebound. Anytime the ball is loose, your player becomes faster. This is so huge, especially in the game that's defensively based, where every stop, every fast break bucket, every loose ball makes a massive, massive difference. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed the video. If you made it to the very end and you're not subbed, I don't know what to tell you. You can definitely hold my nuts any time of the fucking day. Appreciate everybody for the love and for the support, man. Drop a like if you enjoyed the vid. Share it with your friends. More content on the way. 2K22 is an amazing game. We're going to keep grinding. Thank you, and I'm going to catch y'all in another one, bro.